Hi students, all of you, good morning. Welcome to the class. In our today's topic, first we are going to discuss physical properties of ethers. All of you know the ethers are represented as R single bond O single bond R. Here oxygen is having two sigma bonds. In any compound, if the oxygen is going to have two sigma bonds, here oxygen is having the two sigma bonds, that oxygen is going to contain two lone pairs. This is one lone pair, this is the second lone pair. So in the ethers, the oxygen is going to contain two lone pairs of electrons, and this is a bond pair, this is a bond pair, two bond pairs of electrons. In the first pair, you see, you studied the VSEPR theory, Vesper theory. According to Vesper theory, when two lone pairs of electrons and two bond pairs of electrons are there, what is the shape of the molecule? That is the CET bit. What is the shape of the molecule? The shape of the molecule is V shape or angular shape. Otherwise, it is also known as distorted tetrahedral. Why we are saying distorted tetrahedral means, here oxygen is going to contain total electron pairs are 1, 2, 3, 4. Among them, two are the lone pairs, remaining two are the bond pairs. So the oxygen, which is under sp3 hybridization, is going to contain four electron pairs. Generally, we expect that sp3 hybridization means we expect that tetrahedral shape. But because of the presence of lone pairs of electrons, there is a repulsion between lone pairs and bond pairs is going to happen. Then the tetrahedral shape is going to get distorted, that is called as distorted tetrahedral, and the shape of this ether is V shape or angular shape. And you know the structure of water molecule. The structure of water molecule is also similar to ether. We know this is the structure of water molecule, that is the V shape. So water molecule is having the V shape, ethers are having the V shape. In the water molecule as well as in the ethers, oxygen is in sp3 hybridization, or oxygen is going to exhibit sp3 hybridization. So this is about CET regarding first PUC. Right, our topic is physical property. First we are going to discuss the physical property. Boiling point. BP means boiling point. Ethers are going to have low boiling point. Why? Because means ethers are highly volatile. Highly volatile means they get easily evaporate. Once again, the substances which easily get evaporate at the room temperatures, such substances are called as highly volatile substances. So ethers are highly volatile substances, hence they are going to contain very low boiling points or low boiling points. Now you'll get it out. Sir, why the ethers are going to have high volatility? Why they readily escapes? Why they readily evaporate? Why? Because means, if you observe the bond, R single bond, O single bond, R bond, oxygen is more electronegative, alkyl group is less electronegative. Alkyl group means carbon is there. Carbon is less electronegative, oxygen is more electronegative. So this sigma bonded electrons are migrated, are delocalized partially towards the oxygen. Oxygen gets partial negative charge. As a result, alkyl group or the carbon bonded to the oxygen, that is the carbon bonded to the oxygen, is going to contain partial positive charge. Like that, this alkyl group also contain partial, positive charge. So in a molecule, when two poles are there, one is the positive pole, second one is the negative pole. In a molecule, when two poles are there, that molecule is called as a polar molecule. So ethers are the examples of polar molecules, but the ethers are less polar in nature because of the symmetry. Here you can see alkyl groups are there. Alkyl group means carbon hydrogen atoms are there. Carbon and hydrogen atoms are going to have similar electronegativity. So whenever similar electronegativity is there, dipole moment get decreases or polarity get decreases. So ethers are, even though they are polar, but they are exactly less polar in nature. And ethers being less polar in nature and less reactive. So here we have to understand ethers are less reactive in nature. Ethers are having less polarity As a result, ethers are highly volatile because of high volatility. Ethers are going to contain low boiling point. So this is all about one of the physical property, that is boiling point of ethers. And this is the part, first PUC CET part. In ethers, oxygen undergoes sp3 hybridization. In ethers, oxygen contains two lone pairs and two bond pairs. The ethers are going to exhibit the shape distorted tetrahedral or V shape, or it is known as angular shape. So that is all about boiling points of ethers. Okay. Next one is miscibility. Miscibility in water. Miscibility means solubility in water. Either it is called as miscibility or it is called as solubility. Miscibility or solubility of ethers in water. Miscibility. Again, I am taking the ether structure R single bond O single bond R. This is the structure of ether. For my convenience, I am writing like this. Here, oxygen is going to contain two lone pairs of electrons. Okay. I am taking the water molecule because we are going to dissolve. We are going to dissolve ether in the water. Oxygen is going to contain two lone pairs here. Again, I am taking one more water molecule. One more water molecule. So this is a water molecule. Now, we know the water molecule, hydrogen is going to contain partial positive charge. Oxygen is going to contain partial negative charge. Hydrogen is going to contain partial positive charge. Having partial positive and partial negative charges, such molecules are called as polar molecules. So water molecule is an example of polar molecule, right? Here also the same. Hydrogen is having partial positive charge. Oxygen is having partial negative charge. Already I said that in ethers also, alkyl groups. In the ethers, the alkyl groups also contain partial positive charges. Oxygen contain partial negative charge. Yes, all of you know about the formation of hydrogen bonding. Between the highly electronegative, partially negatively charged electronegative atoms to partially positively charged hydrogen atoms, there is a electrostatic force of attraction. There is an electrostatic force of attraction will arise between partially positively charged hydrogen to highly electronegative, partially negatively charged electronegative atoms. There is an electrostatic force of attraction is going to arise. This bond, actually it is not a bond, it is an attraction only. It is not a pure bond, it is the attraction. This attraction is called as, what is the name of this attraction? Text me. What is the name of that attraction? The dotted lines. What the dotted lines are going to indicate between oxygen and between ether and water, the dotted lines. What the dotted lines are going to indicate? What the dotted lines are going to indicate between ether and water molecule? Of course, I know that is electrostatic force of attraction. What is the name of that attraction? Correct, Sushma, Karuna. Karuna, you had to say it is intermolecular. Of course, hydrogen bonds are there. Two types of hydrogen bonds we know. Intermolecular and intramolecular. You had to say it is as intermolecular. Between one molecule to another molecule, if the bond is there, that is called as intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So ether is going to, one molecule of ether is going to have two intermolecular hydrogen bondings. If any molecule which is capable to form intermolecular hydrogen bondings, such compounds are miscible or soluble in water. So ethers are miscible or soluble in water, but not to the maximum extent. Why? Because means here in ether, which group is present? In the ethers, which group is present? Which group is present? Alkyl group is present. Alkyl groups contain carbon and hydrogen. The carbon and hydrogen part is called as, the carbon and hydrogen part is called as hydrophobic part. In the surface chemistry chapter, you studied about cleaning action or cleansing action of soap. In the cleansing action of soap, you studied the structure of that soap molecule, C17, H35CO-Na+ sodium stearate. Once again, C17H35CO-Na+. That COO minus is called as hydrophilic part. C17H35 is called as carbon hydrogen part. That is known as hydrophobic. Phobia means hating nature. Phobia means hating nature. Felicity means loving nature. Once again, phobia means hating nature. Felicity means loving nature. Because of ether is going to contain alkyl groups. Alkyl groups are going to contain the carbon hydrogen part. The carbon hydrogen part is hydrophobic in nature, means it dislikes the water. The alkyl parts of the ether dislikes the water, whereas the oxygen part of the ether likes the water. So within the molecule, two different concepts are there. Alkyl parts are disliking the water molecules, whereas oxygen of ether is liking the water molecule. Now we will get it out, whether ether is soluble in water or not. Yes, of course, due to the formation of intermolecular hydrogen bondings, ethers are miscible or soluble in water, but to the less extent. Yes, I'm going to share the screen to provide some values to you from the NCERT textbook, class 12 chemistry NCERT textbook. On the screen you can see, yes, on the screen you can see the miscibility. Yes, just a minute, I'm going to highlight that one. So miscibility, see here, this is the one. Yes, from this point you have to see. Yes, you are waiting for me also. Okay, see that point, highlighted point. Both ethoxyethane and butane 1-ol. Once again, both ethoxyethane and butane 1-ol are wait a minute. Yes, the screen is coming to you. Okay, sorry for the inconvenience. Once again, the statement. Yes, my dear students, once again, the same instruction. You can enlarge your screen. By touching on the screen, you can enlarge the screen. Then you can see the lines very clearly. This is the advantage. Try to use your two fingers on the screen to enlarge the screen, to enlarge the data. Yes, coming to the point. Once again, both ethoxyethane. What is ethoxyethane? C2H5. See this one. See the top. Ethoxyethane. C2H5O. Ethoxyethane. And butane 1-ol. What is butane 1-ol? CH3, CH2 taken thrice. Nothing but C4H9OH. Once again, CH3, CH2 taken thrice. OH, nothing but C4H9. This is a butane 1-ol. Ethoxyethane and butane 1-ol, they are the examples of dash type of isomers. First, it takes me that answer. Ethoxyethane and butane 1-ol are dash type of isomers. Waiting for your response. I am mixing both CET, PU, NEET, JW, everything. Integrated, the class is integrated. Waiting for the response. Ethoxyethane is there, C2H5O C2H5, CH3 CH2 taken thrice, OH is there, that is butane 1-ol. These two are dash type of isomers. Yes, on the board I am going to explain to you. To get the CET or NEET rank or JE rank, you must be in touch with all the topics. You must be in touch with all the topics. Yes, who's that one? Manisha, correct answer. Functional isomers. So once again, I am writing on the board. Ethoxyethane formula. C2H5, single bond O, single bond C2H5. Ethoxyethane. And butane 1-ol. butane, one ol, represented as CH3. CH2 groups taken thrice. CH2 groups taken thrice. Single bond OH. 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. This is the first carbon. Hence, it is called as butane. One ol. If you see these two compounds, both the compounds are having the formula C4. Both the compounds are having the formula C4H10O. Carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4. C4. Hydrogens. 3, 5, 7, 9, 10. H10O is there. Here also the same. C4H10O is there. Whenever different molecules are going to have same molecular formula, they are called as isomers. And one more thing. Here the functional group is single bond OH. Here the functional group is single bond O, single bond. Between the two different functional groups, if the difference is only one hydrogen, that two compounds are said to be functional isomers. So ethoxyethane and butane one ol are the examples of functional isomers. But in the case of butane one ol is an example of alcohol. Ethoxyethane is an example of ether. Now tell me, among the ether and alcohol, which one is going to soluble more in water? Which one is going to soluble more in water? Here you can see the OH group. OH group is capable to form more number of intermolecular hydrogen bondings. Alcohols are able to form more number of intermolecular hydrogen bondings. Here only oxygen can form intermolecular hydrogen bondings. Here oxygen can form intermolecular hydrogen bondings and hydrogen can form intermolecular hydrogen bondings. As a result, ether alcohols are going to have more number of intermolecular hydrogen bondings. As a result, alcohols are more soluble or more miscible in water than the ethers. Once again, the values, of course, both the compounds are having same molecular formula, but which one is more soluble? Butane one ol is more soluble. How much it is soluble in water? On the screen you can see the statements. Both ethoxyethane and butane one ol are miscible to almost the same extent, that is 7.5 grams and 9 grams per 100 ml of water. How much water should be taken? 100 ml of water is taken in that 100 ml of water in two beakers. 100 ml of water is taken in the two beakers. In one beaker, butane one ol is dissolved. In the another beaker, diethyl ether or ethoxyethane is dissolved. Which is going to be more soluble means butane one ol is more soluble. How much soluble it is? 9 grams per 100 ml of butane one ol is soluble, whereas 7.5 grams of ethoxyethane is soluble in 100 ml of water. So from these values and from that concept, we can understand that ethers are less soluble in water than compared to alcohols. So this is the miscibility or the solubility of ethers in water. And previously I said about boiling points. Once again on the screen you are seeing some values of boiling points. See the formula. CH3, CH2 taken thrice, CH3, nothing but C5H12, called as N-pentane. Next one, C2H5, ethoxyethane. Next one, CH3, CH2 taken thrice, OH, butane one ol. You can calculate the molar mass. If you can calculate the molar mass of N-pentane, 72 grams per mole. The molar mass of ethoxyethane is 74 grams per mole. Molar mass of butane one ol, 74 grams per mole. Yes, tell me whether the molar masses are different or similar. Text me your answer. Whether the molar masses of N-pentane, ethoxyethane, butane-1-vol are different or similar. Whether the molar masses of N-pentane, ethoxyethane, butane-1-vol are different or similar. Yes, very good. Similar. So when the molar masses, wait, when the molar masses are similar, they should contain similar boiling points. They should contain similar boiling points because boiling point is a physical property. Once again, the boiling point is a physical property. Physical properties depends upon molar mass. The physical properties depends upon molar mass. So here, N-pentane is an alkane. Ethoxyethane is an ether, whereas butane-1-ol is an alcohol. So three compounds are given. One is the alkane, second one is the ether, and the third one is the alcohol, having similar molecular masses. Even though they are having similar molecular masses, alcohols are going to have high boiling point because alcohols are able to form more number of intermolecular hydrogen bondings with themselves. That means between one butanol to another butanol, between one butanol to another butanol, more number of hydrogen bondings we will expect than with compared to ethoxyethane and N-pentane. As a result, whenever different molecules of similar molar masses are given, this is the important bit for CET and NEET. Whenever similar molecular masses of different compounds are given, once again my statement, whenever similar molecular masses of different compounds are given, the compound which is going to form more number of hydrogen bondings is going to have high boiling point. So simply we can say that whenever alkanes, ethers and alcohols of comparable molecular masses, here molecular mass is 72, here molecular mass is 74, here molecular mass is 74. So whenever molecules of comparable molecular masses are given, alkanes are going to have least boiling points. Alcohols are going to have high boiling points, whereas ethers boiling points lies between the alkanes and alcohols. So based on this concept, you are having the CET and NEET bits. Please solve those bits from your material, MCQs material. Don't wait for my class. By yourself, you can solve. No need of my class, right? Is there any doubt regarding this topic? If not, I can move for the chemical properties of ethers. Please respond. Is there any doubt regarding this topic? The topic is boiling points and miscibilities. Remaining students are not responding. Means they are very busy in chatting with other persons in the chat boxes. Not in our chat box. In their WhatsApp groups, they are busy. I think so. Whenever I am asking the question, you have to respond. Then only I can know whether you are understanding or not. Without your response, how can I know? Okay, coming to the next point, next topic. As on the screen, you can see now, chemical properties or chemical reactions. Chemical reactions of ethers. Yes, the first chemical reaction is cleavage. Nothing but breaking. Cleavage of carbon single bond oxygen bond. In ethers. So in the ethers, we are going to break the bond between carbon and oxygen. Right, on the screen you can see now. Chemical properties or chemical reactions. Chemical properties or chemical reactions. Chemical properties or chemical reactions of ethers. Very, 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 very important topic for competitive. Every time I am not going to say CET, NEET and JEE. Now onwards, I am not going to say the words CET, NEET and JEE. Simply, I am going to use the word competitive examination. Yes, the first topic is cleavage of carbon single bond oxygen bond in ethers. Cleavage of carbon single bond oxygen bond in ethers. Already I said that ethers are less reactive. So ethers being less reactive, we have to use high temperatures and pressures that are said to be as drastic conditions. Once again, the high temperatures and pressures are said to be as drastic conditions. So the ethers are undergoing the chemical reactions under drastic conditions. The first reaction is cleavage of carbon oxygen bond in the ethers, and it is a reaction with hydrogen halides. Hydrogen halides are represented as HX. Here X is replaced with iodine, hydrogen iodide. X is replaced with bromine, hydrogen bromide. X is replaced with chlorine, hydrogen chloride. X is replaced with fluorine, hydrogen fluoride. Hydrogen halides are HX. They are hydrogen fluoride, hydrogen chloride, hydrogen bromide, and hydrogen iodide. Yes, you will get it out. Sir, why you are writing like this? Why? Because means HF is written like this. HCl is this one. We can write the HBr like this one.